David Holmes with the rerun of a program first broadcast on the 31st of December last year, illustrating one of the most momentous events of 1989, possibly of the whole 1980s, the overthrow of the communist dictatorship in Romania. The recordings were all taken off the air. The well-known identification signal used by Radio Bucharest, which was being listened to more attentively than usual during the closing week of 1989.
This is Radio Bucharest, Romania. This is Radio Bucharest, Romania.
Говорит Бухарест, Румыния. Говорит Бухарест, Румыния.
Ici Bucharest, Roumanie. Ici Bucharest, Roumanie.
Aqui Bucharest, Roumania. Aqui Bucharest, Roumania.
Fala Radio Bucharest, Romania. Fala Radio Bucharest, Romania.
On Friday, the 22nd of December, at around midday local time, it was announced in the Romanian capital, Bucharest, that there had been a popular uprising in the country and that Nicolae Ceaușescu had been toppled from power. News monitors and shortwave listeners automatically reached for their frequency tables and program schedules and were rewarded with some compelling listening.
Revoluția de la 22 decembrie, care a înlăturat dictatura Ceaușescu, este în plină desfășurare. Sprijinit de armată, poporul român își apără, vitejește băreata cucerire, luptând cu toată ființa sa împotriva bandelor teroriste ale fostului regim, care încearcă cu disperare să scape de judecată, făcând noi și noi victime în rândul
populației. Romania, the revolution on December 22nd, that removed the Ceaușescu dictatorship, is in full swing in our homeland. Supported by the army, the Romanian people is defending with might and main its great conquest, fighting with all its might against the terrorist gangs of the former regime that desperately are trying to escape trial and making new and new victims among the population. The victory of the people cannot be avoided. We wish to recall in the following minutes the content of the communique addressed to the country by the Council of the Front of National Salvation that has become the banner of struggle of the Romanian people. Citizens of Romania, we live a historic moment. The Ceaușescu clan that has led our country to disaster was eliminated from power. We all know and we all observe that the victory, which we all live in happiness today with the entire country, is the fruit of the spiritual sacrifice of the people's masses of all nationalities, and in the first place of our wonderful young people that gave back to the entire nation with the price of their blood or feeling of national dignity. A new page has been opened in the political and economic life of Romania. In these hard moments, in these moments of mutations, we have decided to lead the Front of National Salvation, which is supported by the Romanian army, and which groups all sound forces of the homeland, regardless of nationality, all the organizations and groupings that have courageously raised in defense of liberty and dignity in the years of totalitarian tyranny. The aim of the National Salvation Front is the installation of democracy, liberty, and dignity of the Romanian people. From this moment, dissolved are all power structures of the Ceaușescu clan. The government is abolished, the State Council and its institutions cease activity. The entire state power is taken over by the Council of the Front of National Salvation. All the ministries and central organs in their present structure will continue their normal activity, being subordinated to the Front of National Salvation in order to ensure the normal development of the entire economic and social life of our country, Romania. The program of the Front is the following. 1. The abandoning of the leading role of one single party and the establishment of a democratic, pluralist system of governing in Romania. The holding of free elections in this country in April 1990. The separation of the legislative, executive, and judicial powers in the state and the election of all the political leaders for one or two mandates at the most. Nobody can claim state power for life. The Council of the Front of National Salvation proposes that our country should be named in the future Romania. A committee for wording the new constitution will start functioning immediately. Restructuring of the entire national economy on the basis of the criteria of rentability and efficiency. The elimination of the bureaucratic administrative methods in the centralized economic management and the promotion of the free initiative and of competence in the management and leadership of all economic sectors. The restructuring of agriculture and the support of the small peasants' farmers' production. The stopping of the destruction of the Romanian villages. The reorganization of Romanian education according to contemporary demands. The replacing of the structures of Romanian education on humanistic and democratic basis. The elimination of ideological dogmas that have led to so much damage for the Romanian people. The promotion of the true values of humanity. The elimination of lies and the statuation of criteria of competence and justice in all domains of activity. The placing on new basis of the development of national culture. The passage of the press, the radio, and television from the hands of one single despotic family into the hands of the entire people. The observance of the rights and liberties of national minorities, as well as the insurance of their full equality of rights with the Romanians. The reorganization of the entire trading activity of the country, starting from the necessity of meeting the demands with priority of all citizens of Romania. To the same, we'll stop the export of food products, we'll reduce the export of oil products, granting priority to the meeting of the needs of heat and light of the people in this country. The entire foreign policy of Romania should serve the promotion of good neighborliness, friendship, and peace in the world, integrating thus in the process of building a united Europe, a common home of all peoples of our continent. We will pledge to observe the international pledges of Romania, in the first place those referring to the Warsaw Treaty. The promotion of a home and foreign policy subordinated to the needs and interests of the development of the human being, the full observance of the rights and liberties of the human being, including his right of free traveling. We also inform you that professionally and by membership of the council, among others, are Doina Cornea, Ana Blandiana, Mircea Dinescu, Laszlo Tekes, Dumitru Mazilu, Dan Deșliu, General Stefan Gușe, Corneliu Mănescu, Alexandru Bârlădeanu, Silviu Brucan, Domokoș Gheza, Marian Mierlă, and Ion Iliescu. The council is also made up of representatives of the workers, of the higher education students, and of all social categories. We'll be back with further details. This is Radio Bucharest, Romania.
Говорит Бухарест, Румыния. Говорит Бухарест, Румыния. Революция от 22 декабря, которая устранила диктатуру Чаушеску в полном развертывании.
Radio Bucharest. In a dramatic six-language broadcast on Saturday, the 23rd of December. Foreign radio stations broadcasting in Romanian also stepped up their coverage of events in the revolution-torn country, especially Radio Free Europe.
București. Episcopul de Cluj al Bisericii Reformate, Gyulo Nod, a demisionat. Radio București relatează că astăzi va demisiona și episcopul de Oradia, Laszlo Pop. Cei doi prelați au refuzat să acorde sprijinul preotului Laszlo Tökes, a cărui persecutare a generat demonstrațiile de la Timișoara. Timișoara. Corespondentul nostru la Timișoara relatează că incidentele armate par să fi scăzut în intensitate în cursul nopții, după ce ieri s-au purtat lupte pentru preluarea controlului asupra piețelor Operei și Traianului din centrul orașului. Stimați ascultători, ați ascultat ultimele știri redactate de Ileana Giurchescu și Traian Lazar. Următorul nostru magazin de știri îl veți putea asculta la ora 5.
And it was, of course, the Protestant pastor, Laszlo Tökes, whose name you just heard, whose attempted arrest and deportation in the western city of Timișoara had unleashed the mass demonstrations in Romania, which led to the downfall of the Ceaușescu clan.
Radio Europa Liberă. Emisiunea noastră continuă. Aici e Radio Europa Liberă. Emisiunea noastră continuă. Aici e Radio Europa Liberă. Emisiunea noastră continuă.
Radio Free Europe on the 23rd of December in Romanian. The following day, Radio Bucharest itself was back on the air with another multilingual broadcast.
This is Bucharest, Romania. This is Bucharest, Romania. December the 24th, 1989, the third day of Romania's freedom on Christmas Eve. We wish you all Merry Christmas. Listen to the most important news of the last 24 hours. Nicolae Ceaușescu, Elena Ceaușescu, and other members of the former dictatorship in Romania have been arrested and will be put on trial by the people. This news was made public yesterday in a televised speech by Ion Iliescu on behalf of the Council of the National Salvation Front. In the same speech, he said that the Romanian people is now at a revolutionary moment, unfortunately marked by sacrifices. Measures have been taken for organizing activities, for ensuring public vigil and traffic control on all roads. We have in view, he said, to widen forms of work together and participation of the people's masses in support of the actions of the military units, including the setting up of as many patriotic guards as possible for defending their own units, the economic units, other points of general activity, for the needs of the citizens, and also in support of the military units which take action in some hot points. At the same time, Ion Iliescu has announced that Colonel General Nicolae Militaru has been appointed Minister of National Defense, and he's being helped by two first deputies, General Stefan Bușe, head of the Chief of Staff, and Victor Stanculescu. Let us also tell you that all over the country, the entire people, takes united action for ensuring the unfolding of all activities in that country. First of all, in the key sectors of the national economy, and in those concerned with the supply of the population. Everywhere, exciting signs of joy, satisfaction for the revolutionary act, of solidarity with those who have suffered these days are recorded. Moreover, humanitarian aid sent from abroad has begun arriving in the country. The Romanian people receives this material and other aid sent from most various corners of the world with gratitude. Our programs are the mouthpiece of public opinion in Romania, which has learned about the wide international response of the revolutionary events in this country. The foreign programs of the Romanian radio and television ask all foreign radio and television stations and their listeners to send the organizations and people their thanks and the thanks of the Romanian people for their help and solidarity for free Romania. We wish you a Merry Christmas.
Ici Bucarest, Roumanie. Ici Bucarest, Roumanie. Le 24 décembre 1989, la troisième journée de la liberté de la Roumanie, la veille de Noël. Nous vous souhaitons et nous nous souhaitons bonne fête.
Еще раз счастливых праздников по случаю Рождества.
Unusual experience of Romanian carols introduced with seasonal greetings in Russian on Christmas Eve. But the goodwill from Romania rapidly turned in another direction. On Christmas Day, the Front of National Salvation announced the trial, conviction, and immediate execution of Nicolae Ceaușescu and his wife Elena on various charges, including the betrayal of the country and responsibility for the deaths of 60,000 persons. The Radio Bucharest announcer was somewhat carried away by the pent-up emotions of the occasion and spoke about the good news of the death of the Antichrist and the return of liberty to Romania.
Oh, ce veste minunată! A murit Antichristul, a renăscut însă credința noastră în libertate, în puterea noastră de a scrie o nouă istorie, o istorie cu adevărat românească, eliberată de cismele despotilor.
Radio listeners were thankfully spared the horrific pictures which accompanied that same news item on television. That feature on the 4 days in December 1989, which shook Romania, was devised and presented by David Hamgis for Radio Austria International. We hope our colleagues in Bucharest and the other studios in Romania will enjoy a quieter 1990. You've been listening to Austrian Shortwave Panorama. Join us again if you can on the first Sunday in 1990.